Hi, today's problem is in population of 100 students, 64 are PTC testers with genotype that is homozygous dominant, 32 are PTC testers with genotype that is heterozygous, and the last 4 are non-testers with genotype homozygous recessive. And here is the 2 questions. What is the allelic frequency of the allele T? And what is the genotypic frequency of the genotype that is homozygous recessive? If you feel that you can solve this problem, I recommend you to stop video here, try to solve this problem on your own, and when you would be ready, you can run video again, and you can compare your answer with my answer and explanation. So, first of all, PTC is such a chemical that some people can test as a beta test, and some people just don't test it at all. So let's first start with the first question. So what is the allelic frequency? And let me write down all the genotypes that we have here. So we have 64 people. That is capital T, capital T. So we have 64 people. We also have that is testers. We also have heterozygous 32 people, and we have also 4 people that belong to the small t genotype. So as you see, all together we have 100 individuals. And how to find allelic frequency? This would be easy. So if we have 64 individuals here whose genotype would be homozygous dominant, that means that each individual has two dominant alleles, T capital and T capital. So this gives us 128 alleles, that is capital T, because we are diploid, and we have to, if we have 64 individuals, that means that these 64 individuals would have 128 alleles. In this example, for the homozygous dominant, they would have 128 alleles, that is capital T. As for the heterozygous form, we have 32 individuals, and of course 32 individuals would have 64 alleles, but 32 of them would be dominant allele capital T, so 32 plus 32, that is going to be a recessive allele. So altogether, this is going to be 64, but half of them would be dominant allele and half would be recessive allele. And together, this is going to be 64. And as for the homozygous recessive, we have 4 individuals that would have 8 alleles, and all of them going to be small T alleles. So we have 8 alleles here. So now it would be very easy to count alleles. So here we have 128 alleles that comes from the homozygous dominant, plus 32 dominant alleles that comes from the heterozygotes. So together this is going to be 160, and here we have 32 alleles that goes from the heterozygous from the heterozygous people who is also testers. So this two would be testers. And also we have 8 alleles from the non-testers. So altogether this is going to be 40 alleles. And total number would be 200. So 160 plus 40 equals to total number of the alleles 200. Now in order to find the frequency of the allele T, so it is here in heterozygous form and it's present here in homozygous recessive form, we just have to divide total number of the recessive alleles, that is 40, by the total number of the alleles, that is 200. And the answer here would be 0.2. This is going to be frequency of the recessive allele T. Or if you need an answer as a percentage, we have to multiply this number by 100. So this is going to be, if we multiply by 100, this is going to be equal to 20%. So now we can move to the second question. What is the genotypic frequency of the homozygous recessive genotype? So if first question were about alleles, the second question about genotypes. And let's count. We have a total number 100 students, and we have 64 people, that is homozygous dominant, 32 people who is heterozygous, and 4 people who is homozygous recessive. And what is the genotypic frequency? It is very easy. Numbers here are given on purpose, so you can count even without calculator. So 4 would be out of total number of 100 students would be 4%. Or if numbers would be not even, for example, 257 people, and for example, you have to find what is the percentage would be this 4, you just have to divide total number by number of the heterozygotes, homozygous recessive genotype. But in our case, we just have to divide 100 by 4, and the answer would be 0.04. And once again, if we need to give an answer as a percentage, you have to multiply by 100, and the answer would be 4%. And this is to our answers today. This is first question, and this is second question. This is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Goodbye.